Now, what's so lucky about the unluckiest man in the world? That's not him, incidentally, but that's an amusing assemblage of superstitions.
He got killed by a horseshoe.
Yeah, well, this man is either the unluckiest or the luckiest. Depends which way you look at it.
But something it's... like he's had more operations or accidents or anything, well, or bear more in mind... claims direct
things than anybody else, and he's still alive.
Yeah? Bear in mind that we're after places and countries and things beginning with H. So that is about... And if I tell you his name, this may help. His name is Tsutomu Yamaguchi. I say is. He actually died in January 2010. But aged 93, so he lived a long time, so he wasn't that unlucky, you may say.
So, where's the H there with the H?
Yamaguchi would suggest he came from...
Holland.
Harwich.
You can do better than that.
I'd have said Japan.
Japan. Could have come from now think of a place in Japan that begins with H. Okay.
Hiroshima.
Oh, Hiroshima.
Hiroshima, oh, right.
He was...
Hit bomb landed on him and yeah. He bounced off.
No. He was in Hiroshima on business when the bomb went off.
Yes.
He was badly burned. He spent a night there.
He went to hospital in Nagasaki.
The next day, he got on a train, bizarrely, which shows you that even though the atom bomb fell, the trains were working. So he got on a train to Nagasaki, and a bomb fell again. And he was celebrated. He became a sort of hero, but only in his 90s. He was officially recognised as the man who was bombed twice. He claims that there were over 100 people he met who also had that same or a similar experience. And he kind of network of friends. But he was a cheerful fellow. And you see, he lived and looked cheerful and died aged 93. So.
He doesn't look that cheerful, does he?
No, wedged between two mushroom
clouds. It's happening again. Yeah. What are the chances?
Yeah, it is astonishing. He's either the luckiest because he survived an atom bomb twice. Or the unluckiest because...
But he lived in 93, so he didn't have, you know, he was not, his life was not curtailed.
No, exactly. But the thing
is, you know, is the glass half empty?
That's exactly.
Is it half full? Either way, it's radioactive.
Yeah.
Well, so don't drink it.
And he never got on a train again, I can tell you.
But the astonishing thing to me is that you drop an atom bomb on Hiroshima and the train service is working the next day. I mean, in our country...
Keep calm and carry on.
Yeah.
A couple of leaves.
Yeah, that's it for the rest of the winter. It is quite extraordinary.
The wrong kind of bomb. Oh, it's the wrong kind of bomb.
It was clearly the right kind of bomb. It's fine, everybody, don't worry. It's the right kind of bomb.
The right kind of bomb has landed on the 4:30 from Potter's Bar. Please proceed to the nuclear area.
I suspect they weren't privately owned.
The sandwiches have not been affected.